to this morning's third day communion service. Thank you for joining us. You'll hear Hannah with us because she's in our little bubble. So it's really nice to have her with us too. Let's pray. Great and glorious God, we gather to worship you. We lift our eyes to you in reverent awe before your majesty. Generous and merciful God, we come to worship you. We lift our eyes to you, giving thanks for your compassion. Welcoming and empowering God, we worship you. We lift our eyes to you and we celebrate your faithfulness. Holy is the Lord our God and greatly to be praised. Amen. So our call to worship. Come, all that are heavy, all that are carrying burdens so heavy,
Jesus will give us rest.
Come, take what Jesus has to offer, love, forgiveness and grace. Christ will give us peace. Come, find rest and learn from Jesus, for our Saviour will give us rest in our souls. Come, let us worship our God. Let us follow our Saviour who leads us into life. And so we prepare our hearts and minds for confession. Lord Jesus Christ, we confess we have failed you, as did your first disciples. We ask for your mercy and your help. Our selfishness betrays you. Lord, forgive us. Christ, have mercy. We fail to share the pain of your suffering. Lord, forgive us. Christ, have mercy. We run away from those who abuse you. Lord, forgive us. Christ, have mercy. We are afraid of being known to belong to you. Lord, forgive us. Christ have mercy. Almighty God, who in Jesus Christ has given us a kingdom that cannot be destroyed, forgive us our sins, open our eyes to God's truth, strengthen us to do God's will, and give us the joy of his kingdom through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so we praise God's name for his amazing forgiveness and mercy. Glory to the Creator who gives us life.
Glory to Jesus whose love remakes us.
Glory to the Spirit, companion on our journey.
Glory be to God. Amen.
And we affirm what we believe together. Do you believe and trust in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe and trust in his Son, Jesus Christ?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe and trust in the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
And it's going to bring us this morning's reading.
This passage follows on immediately after Jesus had appointed the 12 disciples. According to Mark, the disciples had been appointed for two purposes: to be Jesus' companions and to be sent out by Jesus to proclaim the gospel and to drive out demons. The controversy over the power to cast out demons, which now confronts Jesus, will also confront the 12. Mark chapter 3 verses 20-35. And the crowd came together again, so that they could not even eat. When his family heard it, they went out to restrain him, for people were saying, "He has gone out of his mind." And the scribes who came down from Jerusalem said, "He has Beelzebul, and by the ruler of the demons he casts out demons." And he called to them and spoke to them in parables. How can Satan cast out Satan? If a kingdom is divided against itself, that kingdom cannot stand. And if a house is divided against itself, that house will not be able to stand. And if Satan has risen up against himself and is divided, he cannot stand. But his end has come. But no one can enter a strong man's house and plunder his property without first tying up the strong man. Then indeed the house can be plundered. Truly I tell you, people will be forgiven for their sins and whatever blasphemes they utter. But whoever blasphemes against the Holy Spirit can never have forgiveness, but is guilty of an eternal sin. For they have said, he has an unclean spirit. Then his mother and his brothers came, and standing outside, they sent to him and called him. A crowd was sitting around him, and they said to him, your mother and your brothers and sisters are outside, asking for you. And he replied, who are my mother and my brothers? And looking at those who sat around him, he said, here are my mother and my brothers. Whoever does the will of God is my brother and sister and mother. For the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Here is a story of family turmoil, confusion and distress. Put yourself in Mary's shoes. What would it have felt like to be her? Put yourself in Mary's shoes when Jesus came home with 12 new friends, all excited and high on newfound religious fervour. Wouldn't you begin to think that Jesus had gone out of his mind? And what about when the crowds pressed in and around the house? So that there was not even room enough to eat. Wouldn't you begin to think that Jesus had gone out of his mind? Put yourself in Mary's shoes when rumour came home that Jesus had embraced the leper man and run the risk of such profound contamination. Put yourself in her shoes when Simon's mother-in-law came round to tell the tale concerning how Jesus had broken up her family by seducing her daughter's husband away from an honest trade of fishermen. Didn't you begin to think he'd lost his mind? And what about when four burly men carried their paralysed friend onto the roof and began to dig through to the room below? Put yourself in Mary's shoes when the sensible scribes came down from Jerusalem and attributed Jesus' bizarre behaviour to possession by Beelzebub, the ruler of the demons. Wouldn't you begin to think that Jesus had lost his mind? Here is a story of family turmoil, confusion and distress. Put yourself in Mary's shoes. What would it all have felt like to her? When you are living through times of change, it's not always easy to interpret precisely what is going on. According to Mark, Jesus had initiated a traumatic time of change in first century Palestine. In the person of Jesus, the reign of God was breaking in on the people of God. New and strange things were happening. But how would you have interpreted it all? On one occasion there was a man with an unclean spirit in a synagogue, a man from nowhere. Jesus commanded the unclean spirit to come out, and the possessed man was made whole. Something new and strange had happened. But could you be sure that it was the work of God and not the trick of some false messiah? On one occasion there was a woman in bed with a fever, a man from nowhere. Jesus took her by the hand and the fever left her. Something new and strange had happened. On another occasion there was a leper man seeking cleansing. A man from nowhere, Jesus touched him and said, be made clean, and the leper was healed. There was a paralyzed man let down through a hole in the roof. Jesus said, son, your sins are forgiven. and the paralytic got up and walked. Something new and strange had happened. On one occasion, there was a man in the synagogue with a withered hand, and a man from nowhere, Jesus, said, "Stretch out your hand," and the hand was restored. Something new and strange had happened. But could you be sure it was the work of God and not the trick of some Messiah? When you are living through times of change, as we certainly are now, it's not always easy to interpret precisely what is going on. But how would you have interpreted it all back then? And how do you see it now? Let's pray. Listen, God is calling your name. God knows the hairs on your head. God knows your heart. Listen, hear the good news. God's love endures forever. There is nothing you can do to separate you from God's love. There is nowhere you can go where God cannot find you. Listen, turn back to God and know God's love has always been with you. It's with you now and will lead you home. Heavenly Father, you call us to be your friends and to make friends of others, to recognize in them our brothers and sisters, your family in Christ. And so we pray for ourselves and for the world and its people. We pray for all areas in the world where deep divisions run between ethnic groups because of race, religion, past history, and even right at this moment, political division. Lord, help your people to be your friends and to make friends. Your family in Christ. We pray for our communities where different traditions shape different outlooks on things. Lord, help your people to listen well to each other, that we may learn to live together, knowing that though different, we are your family in Christ. We pray for our own families, where growing up is difficult, where harsh words spoken in anger are not easily taken back, and hurtful or thoughtless actions are endangering relationships. Lord, empower your children to be patient, slow to anger, and to become wise in their speaking and acting as your family in Christ. We pray for those who are in need of your healing touch, for those who are struggling with this new lockdown. We pray for those whose mental health isn't healthy. We pray for those who are physically unwell. Pray for those who are on our pew sheet and have asked for our prayers, thinking especially today of Jean Bentham and Dorothy, Jean and Brian. Alpha and Omega, you are the one who makes all things new. As seasons come to an end, you turn the wheel and the new season begins. Guide us in this time of seasonal change in our lives on the earth and in our world. May the new season bring for us a hope for peace, a hope for justice. May the new season cause us to change our ways to live into your hope for us. May we not despair because of the world humanity created. but may we rejoice because you are our Creator. You made the heavens and earth and make all things new, Alpha and Omega, beginning and end. May we know a new beginning in you, in this moment, in the now. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. We are the body of Christ. In the one Spirit we were all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
I know, I don't put it in. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
I need to change that. Lift up our hearts. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right. It is our duty and our joy, at all times and in all places, to give you thanks and praise, Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. For he is your living word. Through him you have created all things from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you have freed us from the slavery of sin, giving him to be born of a woman and to die upon the cross. You raised him from the dead and exalted him to your right hand on high. Through him you have sent upon us your holy and life-giving Spirit, and made us a people for your own possession. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, and as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood, who in the night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross. We proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. We look for the coming of your kingdom, and with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts, in the presence of your divine majesty, Renew us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. We are here because Jesus has called us, strangers and friends, believers and doubters, the certain and the curious. It's always a mixed company that Jesus gathers and invites to his table, where he meets us, and through him, we who are different are joined to each other. And so, in this moment, we ask him to come, wherever we are, come, Lord Jesus, and fill us with your love, peace, mercy, and grace. Amen. Child of God, the body of Christ. Say together, God of our pilgrimage, you have willed that the gate of mercy should stand open for those who trust in you. Look upon us with your favour, that we who follow the path of your will may never wander from the way of life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and those you love and pray for this day and always. Amen. Stay safe. Spread peace wherever you are. Love and serve the Lord in any way you can. In the name of Christ. Amen. And in these next 4 weeks, the church building may very well be closed, but the church isn't. So do keep in touch. We will do our best to keep in touch with you. We will keep sending you through an updated pew sheet. We will carry on streaming. And if you need us at all, if you want some shopping done, or if you're a person on your own and you're feeling lonely and you need a chat, then please do get in touch. God bless you all.